Okay, so we start Venn diagram. Actually, what is Venn diagram? Okay, Venn diagram is nothing but a logical, you can say, okay, Venn diagram is a symbolically a logical representation of set, you can say. If you take universal set like this, universal set, you know very well what is universal set, in which all the element can be a superset of all the set. Okay, so we can represent the sets by a circle. Suppose to be this is set A, and we can write either inside the circle we can represent the set, or outside it doesn't a problem. Okay, so you A, this is supposed to be B. So this is the representation of set via Venn diagram. Clear? And some operations are there in Venn diagram. We can discuss one by one. Okay, we will discuss one by one the operations on this particular Venn diagram. But what is Venn diagram? This is the representation. Which representation? Which representation, you can say? Universal set. This is universal set U, and these are the sets. You may understand their elements are also right like this. Okay, or maybe if you write the number of element, suppose if you want to write number of element in a set A, then you can write this is set A and number of elements supposed to be 5. This is number of, this is set B, in this number of element is 6. Like this also you can represent. Okay, you may understand this one. Venn diagram, what is actually Venn diagram? Venn diagram is nothing but a logical representation, or you can say the diagrammatical representation of a set, is known as Venn diagram. Okay, so now I'll do operations on sets. Next heading is operations on sets. What is the first operation? Union of two sets. Write down operations on sets. Operations on sets. So first one is union of two sets. Okay, what is union of two sets? Okay, let A and B, A and B are, okay, write down, let A and, but suppose dikh raha hai na, clear?
Yes sir.
Yes sir.
B are two sets, then their union, their union is denoted by symbol this. This is the symbol beta, like U, denoted by the symbol U, and is defined as how to define the union of two sets. A and B is denoted by the symbol U and is defined as A union B. Okay, A union B, X such that X belongs to B, or X belongs to B. What is written here? X such that X belongs to A, or X belongs to B. This is union of two sets. Okay, either A belongs to, X belongs to A or X belongs to B. Okay, note it down. Please note it down. Okay, you may complete it. Okay, so what is the mean of union actually? By the mathematical definition, we can write A union B is nothing but X such that X belongs to A or X belongs to B. But in mathematical way, you can say this. But what is actually union? Now we can see from the example. Suppose you have given two sets A and B. Supposed to be A, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and B is nothing but 6, 7, 8, 9. Supposed to be this, these are two sets. So what is union? A union B is nothing but what? All the elements. Union means you have to take in all elements of A and B. Common elements take at only once. Common element taking only once. Clear? Suppose A union B, so all elements 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. What do you see here? Here maybe 6 is in both the A and B, both the set A and B, but we take only once. 6 only take, we take 6 only once. 6 को सिर्फ एक ही बार लेना है, भले ही दोनों दो बार दोनों में है, ठीक है? So A union B consists of all those elements which are either in A or in B. आप इसको by the definition अगर देखना चाहते हैं तो कैसे देखेंगे? Any element you can take from A union B. Suppose 2 belongs to A union B. So what you see here? This means this implies 2 belongs to A or 2 belongs to B. या तो 2 A में है या 2 B में. Clear?
Yes sir.
A में है या 2 B में. आरे पास हमने हो सकता है इससे भी clear ना हो तो हम एक ऐसा element लेते हैं बेटा जो suppose करिए हम आपको यहाँ पे और अच्छे से समझाने के लिए ये थोड़ा सा एग्जाम्पल सही है नहीं आपके साथ समझ नहीं पाएगा. सपोज कि हम कोई ऐसा एलिमेंट लें जो ए में नहीं हो बी में हो. सपोज 9, 9 बिलोंग्स टू ए यूनियन बी. मे बी फ्रॉम दिस एग्जाम्पल इट इज क्लियर. ओके, 9 बिलोंग्स टू ए यूनियन बी मीन्स व्हाट? 9 बिलोंग्स टू ए और 9 बिलोंग्स टू बी. मतलब यूनियन में जो आएगा वो या तो ए में होगा या तो बी में. Now you may understand, okay? ठीक है? A union B means the sets, the element which is either in A or in
B.
Clear है ना?
Yes sir.
And also some more definition of union. Negation के लिए भी होता है. अगर suppose करिए हमने आपको A union B के लिए एक और definition दिया. सब इंपॉर्टेंट चीज है बेटा, दिमाग है हमेशा यूज करना पड़ता है. ए यूनियन बी, एक्स डज नॉट बिलोंग्स टू ए यूनियन बी. ओके, एक्स सच दैट एक्स डज नॉट बिलोंग्स टू ए यूनियन बी है ना. एक्स सच दैट एक्स बिलोंग्स टू ए यूनियन बी, तो इसका मतलब क्या था? आइदर एक्स बिलोंग्स टू ए और एक्स बिलोंग्स टू B, but does not belong to A union B. That is implies X does not belong to A and X does not belong to B. यहाँ पे word बदल गया बेटा. और की जगह क्या आ गया? And आ गया. X does not belong to A and X does not belong to B. आप समझिए इस चीज को. अगर x a यूनियन b में नहीं है, है ना, x सच दैट x डज नॉट बिलोंग्स टू a यूनियन b, दिस मींस x डज नॉट बिलोंग्स टू a एंड x डज नॉट बिलोंग्स टू b. बल्कि आप इसको a यूनियन b ना लिख करके ऐसे लिखें बेटा, फॉर ईच x डज नॉट बिलोंग्स टू A union B, this implies X does not belong to A and X does not belong to B. कोई भी अभी आपने जो एग्जांपल लिया उसमें कोई भी ऐसा सेट ले लीजिए जो यूनियन में नहीं है, कोई भी ऐसा एलिमेंट ले लीजिए जो यूनियन में नहीं है, ठीक है. सपोज करिए 10, 9 तक था ना, हमने 10 कंसीडर कर लिया. 10 डज नॉट बिलोंग्स टू ए यूनियन बी, दैट मींस व्हाट? 10 डज नॉट बिलोंग्स टू ए एंड 10 डज नॉट बिलोंग्स टू बी ऑल्सो. ओके, सो प्लीज अंडरस्टैंड द डेफिनेशन. And what is the Venn diagram for A union B? Now question is, what is the Venn diagram for A union B? Suppose this is universal set U, this is A, this is B. Okay, if you set all these portions. It's whatever the said portion, this must be A union B. ये जो हमने पूरा said portion लिया है, इसी को हम लोग A union B बोलते हैं. Okay? Okay. Note it down. Note it down, please. Now next, see properties of operation of union. There are some properties of operation of union. What are the properties of operation of union? Properties of operation of union. So, what are the properties of operation of union? Okay, there are some properties for the operation of union. First property is A union B must be equal to B union A. This means commutative law. इसको क्या बोलते हैं बेटा? Commutative law. A union B must be equals to B union A. This is commutative law. That means union must hold commutative law. Union must hold commutative law. Okay. Now the second one is, okay, you know how to prove it. If you write A union B and B union A, actually you merge up the you mix the elements, that means you write combinedly the both elements of both the sets, that's why it holds commutative law. If you want, you can prove it by example or another method also. Okay, what is the method? Proof ki agar baat kare, so proof like this: for each x belongs to A union B, and this implies aapko kya karna hai, A union B or B union A dono equal hai. तो हमको क्या करना है, A union B को, okay, we have to show A union B is subset of B union A and B union A is subset of A union B, then both the sets are equal. If you want to show any two sets are equal, then I had already told you two sets are equal only when A is subset of B and B is subset of A. Clear? So X belongs to A union B. This implies X belongs to A or X belongs to B. And obviously you know, you can write X belongs to B or X belongs to A. And you can write it X belongs to B union A. This is equation number. This implies A union B is subset of B union A. ऐसे ही बेटा आरडी शर्मा वगैरह की बुक में दिया होगा, आप इसको सीखने की कोशिश करिए. क्लियर?
ओके, यस सर.
एंड नाउ आपने क्या किया, एक एलिमेंट एक्स से लिया था ए यूनियन बी में और उसको दिखाया कहा, बी यूनियन ए. इफ ईच एलिमेंट ऑफ ए इज आल्सो एन एलिमेंट ऑफ बी, देन यू कैन से व्हाट, A is subset of A union B में एलिमेंट लिया था, B union A में दिखा दिया, तो A union B किसका सबसेट हो गया? B union A. Okay? Similarly, you can write similarly, no problem. A union B, that means B union A is subset of A union B also. In the same manner you can write. Okay? X को हम B union A में लेके दिखाएंगे, X belongs to B और है ना, in the same way. So from 1 and 2 what? From 1 and 2, 1 and 2, question number 1 and 2, एक में आप देख रहे हो कि A union B, B union A का subset है, and another equation B union A is subset of A union B, so obviously A union B is equals to B union A, both the sets are, so in this manner you can show the union holds commutative law. Union क्या करता है? Commutative law को hold करता है. Okay? So note it down. Okay. I hope you completed this one also. Okay. Now some more properties there. A union B union C. It is given in book. Please see. You can learn it. Okay. A union B union C is A union B union C. A intersection phi is A simply. A intersection phi is A. That means what? है ना? Phi से किसी का भी union, sorry. A union phi is phi. A union phi is A. अगर आप किसी भी set का union phi से लेंगे तो फिर से वही set आ जाएगा. Why? Because there is no element in phi. Okay. Now, A union A is again A, U in union A is again U, law of U, there is A union phi is A, law of identity, है ना? आपको अगर सर ये सब याद करने का क्या फायदा है? बेटा direct question पूछे जाते हैं आपके exams में, direct in the sense, maybe in your home exam or unit test, maybe it is subjective, but obviously in optional exam directly it is asked that either this one law is known as, that means A union phi is equals to A, this law is known as, so what you can say, this law is known as law of identity and phi is identity of U. What is the meaning of identity? You know, you understand about the additive identity, multiplicative identity in previous classes. That means in natural number, in whole number, if you see, then for the real number, which one is the additive identity? 0 is the additive identity, 1 is the additive identity, which one is the additive identity? You know, okay? Additive identity means if you add that particular identity in any number, then again you will get the same number. So 0 is the additive identity of real number. Real number are numbers, okay? So, but multiplicative identity is what? 1 is the multiplicative identity, because if you multiply 1 in any number, then again we get that particular number. In the same manner, if we take union of a set by the phi, then again we get that particular set. That's why phi is the identity of union. Identity of union. Here written it is phi is the identity of union. So you may remember it. Okay. And afterwards there is intersection of two sets. Okay. So अभी बेटा बच्चे धीरे धीरे आ रहे हैं, दैट्स वाई हम इसको अभी स्टार्ट नहीं करेंगे, क्योंकि थोड़ा धीरे पढ़ाएंगे, बच्चे आ जाए, जैसे सेकंड चैप्टर से अगर बच्चे देखें सेकंड चैप्टर ऑनवर्ड्स, तो वो सारे के सारे पढ़ने के लिए सब रेडी हो. ओके, सो आई एम नॉट गोइंग टू स्टार्ट इंटरसेक्शन ऑफ सेट्स टूडे. ओके, वी कैन स्टार्ट इंटरसेक्शन ऑफ सेट टुमारो, बट इट्स माई हम्बल रिक्वेस्ट, दैट्स योर होमवर्क, यू कैन डू मोर एंड मोर क्वेश्चन बेस्ड ऑन union. See here some example is there. Example number 12, 13, and simply A union B you can find. A is this, B is this, then what is the value of A union B? है ना? और एक-एक example को आप अच्छे तरह से पढ़ें. Union के बाहर Venn diagram को देखिए. Okay?
सर आई हैव अ क्वेश्चन.
यस टेल मी.
सर ऐसे प्रूफ्स एग्जाम में भी आते हैं?
एक्चुअली ये प्रूफ थोड़े से कह सकते हो कि स्टैंडर्ड से ऊपर है, लेकिन क्योंकि साइट्स बुक में दिया हुआ है.
यस सर.
साइट बुक्स में दिया हुआ है इसलिए हम आपको ये चीज बता रहे हैं. ठीक है.
ओके सर.
ऐसा और जनरली हम इसको सिर्फ दो ही के लिए प्रूफ करते, मतलब यहाँ तो हमने बता दिया, लेकिन आगे डी मॉर्गन लॉ है और डी मॉर्गन लॉ के लिए ही इसको हम प्रूफ कर रहे हैं. ओके
ओके सर.
डी मॉर्गन